दैट इज डिवीजन ऑपरेशन इज नॉट कॉम्यूटेटिव लाइक दैट द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू सेट्स इज कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू सेट्स इज नॉट कॉम्यूटेटिव ए क्रॉस बी एंड बी क्रॉस ए आर नॉट इक्वल सो नेक्स्ट इज डेफिनेशन ऑफ रिलेशन लेट ए एंड बी आर एनी टू नॉन एम्प्टी सेट बी एनी नॉन एम्प्टी सेट देन एनी सबसेट ऑफ ए क्रॉस बी इज कॉल्ड रिलेशन फ्रॉम ए टू बी फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन अबव एग्जाम्पल ए इज 1 2 3 बी इज ए बी देन ए क्रॉस बी इज दिस सेट कंटेन्स 6 elements. So the relation from A to B, that is out of these 6, take any 2 element, 3 element, 1 element, for example 1A, 2A and 2B. So this is the subset of this R1 is subset of A cross B, and so this R1, that is 1A, 2A and 2B is one of the relation from A to B. So under this relation, one is related to A, because when we say one is related to A, why? Because 1A belongs to R1, present in R1. But A1 does not present in R1, and so A is not related to 1, but 1 is related to A. That is, A is related to B and B is related to A. These two are different things. If A is related to B, then you cannot say that B is related to A. If both AB and BA present in the relation, then we can say that A is related to B, also B is related to A. So under this relation R1, 2 is related to A, 2 is related to B. Okay. So similarly, we can take R2. Another relation, that is, take any subset of this A cross B, any subset. So when set becomes a subset of this set, by using the definition of subset, we can say that we take any 2 element, 3 element, 1 element from these 6 elements. If we can take all 6 elements in the set, then it's also becomes a subset of this set. So this set contains 6 elements, and so we have 2^6 subsets of this A cross B. That is, we have total 2^6 relations from A to B, different relations from A to B. So we can take another relation, suppose 1A, then 2B. And 3A. Also, we take the element 3B. So these are the 4 elements from this set A cross B. So this is one of the relation from A to B. So then we can find A cross A. So what is A? A is the set 1 2 3. Then what is A cross A? Contains the element 1 1 1 2 1 3 2 1 2 2 2 3, then 3 1 3 2 and 3 3. So contains total 9 elements, because A contains 3 elements. So this is the set A cross A. Then subset of A cross A is the relation from A to A. So instead of from A to A we can say that is relation on A. So we take subset of A cross A. Let notation is R3, R1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, and 3, 2. This is the subset of A cross A, and so is the relation on A, is one of the relation on. And total, this set contains A cross A contains A cross A contains total 9 elements, and that's why this set we have total 2^9 subsets of A cross A. That is, we have total 2^9 relations on A. Then next is the definition of equivalence relation. Let A be any non-empty set and let R be a relation on A, that is subset of A cross A. Then the relation R is called an equivalence relation on A, on the set A, if the following properties are satisfied. Number one, property number one, reflexive. That is, if R is reflexive, that is what? X related to X for all X belongs to A. Means every element of set A related to itself, then we say the relation is reflexive. Number two, property number two, R is symmetric. R is symmetric. That is what? If X related to Y, then Y related to X. And this is true for all X and Y belongs to A. That is, if one element related to other, then the second one also related to first one. Then we say the relation is symmetric. Number three, R is transitive. So when R is transitive, that is, if X related to Y and Y related to Z, then X related to Z, for all X, Y, Z belongs to A. If this is true, then we say the relation is transitive. And if these three properties are satisfied by the relation R, then we say the relation R is an equivalence relation on that set.